We're going to take you all around Superior today and show you what great surprises that this city has in store for you. You ready to go?
Yeah, let's go.
Come on, let's have an adventure today. So right here, this is called Atlantis. So if you look down here, what they'll do is this is a climbing mountain. So you can climb any one of these mountains right through here. Now, if you follow this down and around, you're gonna see the old tunnel down here. So the old tunnel for the 60 was around that corner right here. Now there are two cars located at the bottom of this ravine. Now this area was built by prisoners. This was so difficult to build this stretch of roads, they had a prison camp right down here. So at that prison camp, they built this highway, and it took 3 years for them to blast all the way through to go up this range. And if you spent one day on this, not only did you get paid, they took one day off of your sentence. So it was really a pretty intriguing thing, but a lot of people lost their lives putting this through here. Back when they used to have more running water through here, that they used to come down, and this is where the party spot was, and they would come down here and go swimming. So this is really a beautiful place. Now, if you walk over here, what you're gonna see is, now that's the old Superior Road right there that goes down. Now there is a original tunnel that they blasted through there. Now that is no trespassing, so you probably can go down there. But the number one swim hole was right down here. And this is an intriguing place. This is absolutely gorgeous. Now there's an unbelievable little area down there that it's worth going down to see, but this is pretty treacherous getting down, so realize that it's going to be pretty difficult. But it's really neat down at the bottom of that, basically oasis in the middle of nowhere. So here we are at Oak Flats. Look how quick it was to go right up the hill, how fast we've been able to kind of do all this stuff, right? So there are the wiki-ups, and then this is where the Apaches still come. And you know, if you want to see more about this and save Oak Flats, then you can watch one of these videos above. But how cool that was and how quick that was. Now, there's two parts to this, kinda. There's this part here that loops around, and then there's an upper half. Now, they still do a lot of ceremonial dances, and I won't get into it a lot because this is just showing you basically how easy it is to get here, but definitely come here. The Apaches still come here today, and they still hunt acorns. And they have been doing this for hundreds of years, and this is sacred ground to them, so respect it. You know, and make sure when you leave Oak Flats that you don't miss this top area with the crosses here and all the little like cool stuff that's over here on all these trees. There's all these little people, and I would like to know what that is. So if anybody knows exactly what that is, please leave it in the comments. It's awesome. And but they're on all these trees around here. But please remember that, you know, this is no different than it would be somebody's church. So if you think about it in that ways, then please respect it.
This is a holy worship site.
Oh, So at the end of the trail up to 60, in between Superior and Miami, right, is the Pinto Valley Mine. Now, a lot of people don't realize that you can go down there, and there is Forest Service down there, and it's awesome. Now, it is closed today, but if you'll notice, there's the Haunted Canyon Trail, and that trail is on some of the hiking maps, and it is gorgeous down there. The Iron Bridge is really awesome, and we've got that in the video above if you'd like to see it. Now we're going to make the loop back to Superior, but we're going to go by the old ancient cattle pens. One thing to make sure of is don't miss the signs. The signs are there for 203. Just make sure you keep your eye out. Now, you will be going through mining areas and you'll be thinking, I shouldn't be here. Well, they have to keep these roads open for those trails. They can't tell you you can't be here. So don't think you're on the wrong trail. Just follow the signs, though. We didn't follow the signs, did we, Jay?
No, we got a lot.
Oh, we went way to hell. Okay, that's enough. Let's get back in the truck while we can. Be extremely careful when you get off of there and make sure that you have plenty of room. It's pretty bumpy getting off there, and you want to make sure the cars behind you on 60 don't rear end you. So you pull into this parking lot here, and the rock walls that go up are right over in here, in that area right up there, that go up all the way over the top of that hill. Now, this road here will take you to the pens. Probably about 10 minute walk down there will take you to the ancient pens. You know, one of the comments we finally got was that it possibly could be pens for the animals that were pulling the ore carts. And, you know, because there had to have been hundreds of those animals. I mean, I can't even imagine how many there were, but it had to be a lot. And so I can see, because there's also what looked to be a man-made reservoir, right, James?
Yes.
Up there, that we were kind of curious to what that was up there. So if there was large amounts of cattle, oxen, mule, they definitely wouldn't need a lot of water. So it logistically, though, I don't know if the Silver King mine, it would have made sense to have them all the way up here. But these pens are spectacular to come see. So this is definitely a stop that, again, we just were looking for, you know, the lost ruins, and guess what we found? These pens. So don't be afraid to stop. Are we ready to head to Superior?
Yeah, let's get to Superior.
Let's do it. Now, if you want to take a nice hike in town, this is the old 60. Now, one thing that might throw you is, you see right here, there's no trespassing. And, you know, that's not right. You can walk here. And here I'll prove. Come over here. And this is the Legends of Superior Trail. Now, you can't have a, you know, any motorized vehicles, but there's a lot of cool stuff down here. This is the old road, and there's a couple of old mines down there that they used to run ox carts, ore carts, run through this valley, and they used to mine right up in this left. They mine basically all over this area, but you can take this, and the old bridge is down there.
The old hopper.
The old hopper. And so one thing you can see is we have a video on most everything that we've done. We had a video, but we wanted to show people how easy it was to actually go do this stuff. Now, this only takes water, right? This is as easy a hike as you're going to get. Go as far as you want to go. It will go all the way up the valley if you want to go up the valley. But it was still a fun hike. We had a good time.
Yeah, I really like this spot.
You know, so this is an easy trail, but it is legal to hike here, even though that sign says no trespassing. Now, we got this from the locals, and they actually have it, you know, they have it on their listing of things to do.
this trail is connected to the other trails you'll be doing if you're at Pinal City.
Well, so James, I'm standing on a corner in Superior, Arizona. Oh, that's not how that song goes, is it?
No.
I think it's Winslow, right?
It is Winslow.
Hey, we're standing in on the corner, basically, of Superior, Arizona. And if you look down the street, this is just a cool little town, right? So we went around all of it and all the cool things there are to do. Now, the crown jewel of this downtown area is the Hotel Magma. You know, the Hotel Magma has been completely redone, and it is absolutely beautiful. It's on the National Historic Registry, which means they basically had to rebuild it as it was when it was new here in the early 1900s. It's a gorgeous place, and if you ever want to do maybe a two-day stay and not try to rush all the stuff we did in one day today, it'd be a great place to stay. They also have a prickly pear festival that brings a lot of people in. They have the downtown has still got a bunch of charm and just a cool place to go. We're going to go inside and take a look at this hotel, but you know, definitely support these towns, because the last thing we want them to do is be like Pinal City, right? I mean, that's the last thing we want. So if you followed us so far, you know where we're at. Me and James have coined this the Circle K Ruins, because how many Indian ruins can you find that's right across the street while you're getting gas at Circle K, which we did earlier today, right? So if you look around, here you are, you walk down, go down to the end of the street, and those ruins are right on the other side of that tree line. Now I would suggest that you tread lightly. This is, you know, private property. It is a church. I can't see them not wanting to preserve this, but here you are. This is an easy one. So right through these trees, there's a little trail, and you'll see pottery shards and all kinds of stuff over there. Walls. All this area was completely Indian ruins. So, you know, we hate to see it like this, but it is what it is.
So, a little bit on the other.
One more stop and we're out of here, James.
About to wrap up Superior.
So here we are at the last stop today. Now, they've got it closed, but it's supposed to be open at the end of this month. This is where Matty Earp's grave is. This is where the Pinal City, basically, cemetery is at. Now, you'd run down this road and you'd hang another left. And the key I would tell anybody is make sure that you watch for the power lines. And you'll take two lefts. And then make sure that you ended up going back south, because you can see the highway and you can see the line, power lines right over you. So keep going when you go left down here. So two lefts after you go through between the white buildings, and you'll go right to it. So there you are. That's our tour of Superior. It's been a great trip. We're going to come back regularly. We're going to actually have some meetups out here and support the people and support the businesses of Superior. J.Schreck
and James.
Man, we did this town. Let's go find another one.
Yep.